Hi everyone, in this video we will learn about function parameters. And to explain this thing, I will create a very simple function. So let's say I am creating a function named void showStudent. And to this function, I will pass some parameters. For example, I can pass an ID that is an integer. Then I can pass an string that is the name of the student. Then I can pass another integer that is age. And let's say I can also pass date of birth. So we have multiple parameters for this function. And one more thing, you can have trailing comma in your function parameters as well. Little cool thing. So now we have a function showStudent that takes 1, 2, 3, 4 parameters. Now whenever I will call this function, I need to pass these 4 values, and inside the function body I will just print the values. So let's say we have print statements to print all the values. Now if I call the function, let's say I will call showStudent. Now if I run the code, I will get all the values. Now the problem here is, sometimes you might want to send only 2 parameters for this function. For example, for a particular student, I just want to pass ID and the name. And I don't want to pass age and DOB. So in that case, what we can do is, we can pass some default value for age and DOB. Let's say I can make age nullable and DOB nullable as well. And for these 2 parameters, I can pass null and null. And if I run the code, I will get the output. And for age and DOB, I am getting null. Now I can add if else to make sure if the values are null, it should not get printed. But that's another thing. The point is, here I am passing null values for the parameters that are not required. And you do not need to do this thing, because Dart supports optional parameters. And you can make your parameters optional by wrapping up inside a square braces or curly braces. First, we will start with square braces. So if I wrap these parameters, age and DOB, inside a square bracket, then what will happen is, now these 2 parameters are optional. And if I don't pass these 2 parameters, then I am not getting an error. And if I run the code, I will get null null. And this time I do not need to explicitly pass null for these 2 parameters, because parameters wrapped inside square braces are optional. You can pass them, and if you don't have the values, you can ignore these optional parameters. And one more thing that you should notice is, whenever you are making your parameters as optional, it should be nullable as well, because the default value is null and we cannot assign null to a variable unless it is marked as nullable. So if I remove this question mark, I will get a compilation error, and it is saying that parameter age can't have a value of null because of its type, but the implicit default value is null. And that is why we are getting this compilation error. And to fix this thing, what we can do is, we can make our parameter nullable. But what if you don't want to make the parameter nullable? In that case, you can provide a default value for your optional parameter. For example, I don't want to make the age nullable here. Then what I can do is, I can remove this question mark, and I can define a default value for my age. Let's say 15. Now I do not need to make age nullable, because if I don't pass any value, the default value is 15. So if I run the code, I am getting 15. Now you can also make your parameter age nullable with the default value. In this case, if I pass null for the age, let's say I am passing null, then in this case, null will overwrite value 15. So if I run the code now, you can see we are getting null. So whenever you create optional parameters using square braces, either you have to supply a default value, or you can make the data type nullable. and this thing is called optional positional parameters. Now another thing that we have in Dart is called named parameters. Now let's say you have a function that have a lot of parameters. For example, I am a programmer and I am reading the code. Now it might happen that the function that I am seeing is defined in some other file. In that case, I will get confused, like for what we have this null. So it is confusing when we have a lot of parameters, and to simplify the thing and improve the readability of the code, we have named parameters. So if you want to create named parameters, in place of square braces, you have to use curly braces. So if you wrap your parameters inside a pair of curly braces, then these parameters are now named parameters. And whenever we need to pass this kind of parameter, that is named parameter, we have to specify the name of the parameter as well while calling the function. As you can see, I am getting a compilation error here because the third parameter is the named parameter and I am passing this parameter value without the name. So to fix this thing, what I can do is I can write the parameter name as well. And named parameters are by default optional. So whenever you are defining a named parameter, either you have to give a default value or you have to define your parameter type as nullable. For example, I remove the nullable type here. As I have a default value for this age, I am not getting any error here. But here I am trying to pass null, that is not acceptable for this parameter, that is not null. So here I can pass either a value or I can ignore this parameter because named parameters are by default optional. So if I call the function like this, I will get the output. You can see I am getting 15 as the age. And if I pass the value, let's say I need to pass age as 17 and DOB as my date of birth. So I am getting the values here. Now, if I remove the question mark from this DOB, I will get an error because I have not supplied a default value for this DOB and it cannot accept null. And that is why I am getting the compilation error. So if you want to have named optional parameters, then either you have to make your variables nullable or you have to supply a default value. Now you can also make all your parameters as named parameter. For example, I can wrap everything inside the curly braces and now all parameters are named parameters. And either I need to make all the data types nullable or I need to supply default values. So I will make everything nullable. And now I am getting error here in place of calling the function because all parameters are named parameters now. And to call the function, we need to supply parameter names as well. So here I can write showStudent and I can pass ID as 1 and all the other values with names. And now if I will run the code, I will get the output as you can see here. So it is working absolutely fine. So we learned about optional positional parameters, named parameters, and named parameters are by default optional. But what if you need to make a named parameter as a required parameter or a mandatory parameter? In that case, there is a keyword that is required. So if you want to make your named parameters as mandatory or required, you can prefix this required keyword before the data type. Now in this case, ID and name are required parameters. And if we don't pass name and ID, we will get a compilation error. For example, if I remove name, you can see I am getting an error. But if I pass name, in that case, the error is gone because in this case, only ID and name are the required parameters and all the other parameters are optional. So if I run the code now, I will get ID and name the default value for age and null for DOB. So it is working absolutely fine. In case of named parameters, you can also use colon to define a default value. So I used equals to, and now I am using a colon to define a default value. This will work as well. If I run the code, I will get 15. But if we try to use this colon in case of optional positional parameters, then let's see what happens. So we have, let's say, show student 1, and I have an optional parameter here. Let's say I have string name, and here I want to write a default value that is no name. In this case, we are getting an error. So in case of positional optional parameters, you have to use an equals to define a default value. So this is how you can use named parameters, positional optional parameters, and default parameters in your Dart function. That is all for this video. Thanks for watching.